बने ठन चली बोलो है जाती रे बन ठन चली. एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट समथिंग रियली रियली योर फर्स्ट पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट. नॉट योर, सॉरी. And welcome back to my channel, Alive to Tell a Tale. My name is Sharmishta and I am back with yet another video from my Study in Ireland series. Today we're at part 12. I hope that everybody who's watching this video is healthy, wealthy and fine. I personally wasn't feeling great in the past few weeks. Everything that was happening with my channel, not being able to find a job as soon as I graduated because of COVID, and the gap that has been increasing between my studies and my first job after my master's has made me super worried about what's going on. So because of that, I was suffering from a severe migraine headache that lasted for more than a week. Now in times like these, when you're not with your family, you're in another country and you don't know where to go, what does one do? Specifically when you're a student, things get a little more tougher. Do you go to a doctor? Do you go to a pharmacy and get medicines from them directly like you do in India? So stay tuned to know all about healthcare in Ireland. GP. Now you're going to hear this word a lot when you fall sick when you're in Ireland. GP stands for General Practitioner. Every local has to be registered with a GP who works at the closest vicinity of their permanent address. For any small or big issue, their first point of contact for medical attention is their local GP and the clinic that they're registered with. This GP and clinic is responsible for maintaining all your medical records, and they will also refer or recommend you to another specialist if need be. For example, if you are dealing with a problem that is way out of the general practitioner's league, then he will suggest you a specialist. He will write you a formal letter, and that is only when some specialist is going to see you. Otherwise, they won't see you. I'm serious. No pharmacy is going to give you a medicine without this letter. No lab is going to carry out any tests like it happens in India. So basically, GP is your go-to for any problem. Basic medicines you'll get if you go to the pharmacy directly, but the medicines that need prescriptions, nobody's going to give you without this letter from the GP. Now, what about non-Europeans? For people who come here on work purpose, for example, if there is an inter-company transfer where people are coming from a different country to work in Ireland, then their insurance is taken care by the organization, and the first thing that they are asked to do is to go and get registered with a local GP. Now, what do you do with students? What do students do? So the best thing that Irish universities do is that every university has their own student healthcare. If you have any problem, any medical issue going on, the first thing you have to do is call up your university healthcare and get an appointment for yourself. Now, these appointments are way cheaper than what you would get outside at a GP. Once you're checked, if they think that you need any exception with your assignments, if you need a leave or if you need to see a specialist, anything and everything will be looked after by this doctor. They're going to write you a letter that would work for all these purposes. Example, prescription, getting an exception for the assignment, or seeing a specialist doctor, or to get an appointment with a specialist doctor. Also, for as long as you're a student, you also have your insurance. Now, for everybody who's going to go and get their GNIB done or get their GNIB renewed, you guys know that it's a must to have a student insurance to get your visa renewed. I personally have never gotten the chance to utilize the insurance, but every student has a student insurance that can be utilized. In the recent times, I heard someone say that if you have spent more than 50 euros for any medical attention, then that will be reimbursed by your student insurance. Now, what happens after your course is completed? Because as long as you're in the university, you can get appointments based on your student card. But once your course is done, your student card is not valid and will not allow you to get appointments in your student healthcare center. So, out of my personal experience, I would suggest that the first thing you do after you're graduated is go to a clinic that's closest to your house and go and get yourself registered with a GP. Like I said before, it's going to be way more expensive than what you were paying. Like, the difference is going to be like when I was going to my healthcare at UCD, I paid 25 euros for two appointments, but outside each appointment is going to be anywhere between 65 to 80 euros. Now, ideally how I went about it is I literally saw what insurance is costing me the least and I invested in that. But if you think that it is very important in your opinion, then go looking for what are the top 5 insurance companies that are most valued in Ireland and just pick one of them. If you guys want me to make an individual video on student insurances and what are the different insurances available here, then please let me know in the comment section below and I'll make a video for you on that. So I'm quickly going to tell you my story just so that you understand what you should do or what you should not do. I have not registered myself with any local GP yet. In times of COVID, the market is so tight that now if I want to go and get myself registered with a GP, no GP or no clinic are ready to take new patients. They are only going to treat existing patients because of the chaos that is happening because of COVID at the moment. So I'll tell you the problem first. The problem is that I got a severe migraine headache. I've had migraine for a few years now, but it was never this severe. I never needed medication for it. It would always come under control with some rest. But this was getting severe. The last time this happened, I was in the university, so I got myself treated there and the pain never happened again. But it happened after a year now and I just could not go back to the doctor I went to last time. So very obvious that I first tried to approach the doctor I saw last year in my college, but they simply said that it has been way too long after I have graduated, so it's going to be difficult for them to consider me as a patient again. But they did suggest me to call a few government hospitals and try and get an appointment based on the emergency category. Now when I called the government hospitals, I managed to get an appointment with a nurse on a phone call, and the nurse spoke to me because she's the one who's going to hear my problem, ask me a few questions and then decide if I come under the emergency category or not. She asked me basic questions like, did you vomit? Are you able to see properly? Like, is your vision affected? Are you eating properly or no? And then finally she decided that my issue does not come under a serious emergency issue, and she just suggested me that go down to the pharmacy and ask them what you should be taking, and if it still doesn't get better in a week, then you can get back to us. Now, headache is something that I'm sure I'm not bleeding, I'm not coughing or anything to show people how severe it is, but it was really severe. And finally, after making 10,000 calls to different hospitals and hearing the same thing after and after again, I realized how big of a mistake it is for not getting registered with a local GP as soon as I graduated, because you're not backed up by your university anymore. I finally managed to find an appointment, an online doctor appointment on Web Doctor, where I got to speak to a doctor. There is like a 15 minute time frame where you book an appointment with the doctor, you get to talk to him, you can tell them what problem you're going through, and the least they can do for you is refer you to another doctor, that is, give you a referral letter, or what they can do for you is prescribe a medicine that you can go and show to the pharmacy, because a migraine headache medicine does not come over the counter, it needs a prescription. I finally managed to get a prescription and I paid €29 for 6 tablets, but it seems that I cannot get a second round after these 6 tablets are over, so kanjus ki tarah I'm having it now. Anyways, so that's my story. This is for all the people who are trying to understand how healthcare works in Ireland. It is not in great state, to be honest, and COVID has made it even worse. I know that there are so many people who would say that healthcare is way better in other places like Canada, Australia, and they are right. If this is something that will help you decide if you have to choose Ireland or not, then here you have it all, and I hope this video has helped you. That is all for today, guys. If you like my video, then don't forget to hit the like button. Don't forget to drop a comment in the comment section below. I would be more than happy to answer your questions. If you have any suggestions on what I should make next, then please drop your ideas in the comment section below. Don't forget to click the bell icon to get a notification every time I post a new video. Until next time, bye-bye. Dances with the moon, but I do know that my heart beats faster. Who to whom? Is that local GP? Must be love. It must be love.